and reassert our support to our brave armed forces that counter terrorism always beside the Egyptian police. The church added that it was asking from God condolences to the families of the victims and recovery for the injured.
Welcome back. Well, to shed more light on this, we have the pleasure to have this phono with Dr. Al-Sadiq Abdurrahman, Professor of Project Development, Ain Helwan University. Good afternoon, Dr. Abdurrahman.
Hello, good afternoon.
Dr. Abdurrahman, as an expert and a professor in development projects, how does the development in Sinai address terrorism?
Firstly, I would like to express my deepest condolences for the people who were killed yesterday in such bad occasion. I understand that one officer and about 10 soldiers
yes.
were killed in such injuries.
Yes.
Okay. In my opinion, Egypt is working on a plan to attract the Egyptians to settle in the Sinai Peninsula by implementing development projects and providing job opportunities. Also, the Egyptian government is hoping this plan will also boost the national economy and preserve national security in Sinai. Also, the development of Sinai tops the priority list of the political leadership in Egypt. The plan to establish new roads network in Sinai that would serve as a basis for future development in Sinai. Also, several mega development projects in Sinai have been built in the last few years. These include road bridges and the tunnel projects that will contribute to the development plan of the Suez Canal access.
Yes,
also, Egyptian State Information Service, which is affiliated with the Egyptian presidency, revealed the government plans to settle millions of Egyptian in Sinai. The urban communities will be established based on economic access, such as agriculture projects, touristic projects, also industrial, as well as schools, universities, hospitals, and infrastructure projects in general. The local community will have access to rehabilitation and the training program. Also, development projects and the reconstruction of Sinai is important to address its population shortage. They see this as the best way to attract residents to live there, which will have a positive impact on the political, economic, and also the security level in such area. The spending allocated for this project is a step on the right way to turn the Sinai from a hazardous breeding ground of problems and the crisis to a zone of welfare, prosperity, and the popularity, and so on.
Yes. So, Dr. Abdurrahman, what are the most important facilities that the Egyptian state is providing to the Sinai people?
Yes. Also, the government is building many other projects, such as the four tunnels, two of them South Ismailia and two others in Bor Said governments in addition to the demobilization of Ahmed Hamdi tunnel to connect Sinaia with the bank of the Suez Canal, I mean West Bank, Ismailia, Borsaid, and Suez as well. Also, many projects I talked about, houses, hospitals, and also roads, networks, and bridges. So, in my opinion, the development of Sinaia is the only way to prevent all these tourist terrorism in Sinaia.
The Sinai people and families are helping the Egyptian government in the development process. How can we benefit from the families in Sinai?
Okay, in Sinai we have some shortage in the infrastructure still yet. But after complete development of the infrastructure and the services projects, I'm sure that the people there in Sinaia will feel prosperity and will feel will live in secure region.
Yes, of course, the youth also in Sinai plays a very important role. What do we expect from the youth in Sinai?
Okay, so in my opinion also, I hope that the Egyptian government allocate more money, more millions of money for all projects to develop Sinai.
Yes, you mean a suitable budget?
Yes.
A suitable budget for the budget. Projects?
Sinai deserves more money for development.